What's up, everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Lego Star Wars The Complete Saga! We're gonna start episode 5! We're really moving up on the world here. First thing first! So, super story! Ooh, it's a dark time. Ooh. I never really understood this, though. I mean, even though, yeah, they're still being chased, they dealt a huge crushing blow to the Empire. They blew up their battle station with a single torpedo. I mean, come on. Come on, guys. You can be a little more excited about your victory. Just a little. Oh god, the last thing I want to see right now is more snow. Just like pass out all over again from like the blood rush to his brain or something. I mean, I don't know. I can't vouch for that, you know, actuality, but that's what I would think. Oh, Fridell, stop it! Oh, my cat is driving me nuts again. Hey, stop it! Be weird, like when one of the guys like flying backwards. It's like I can't see what the hell's going on. Yes, because those little tiny guns are gonna work amazingly against those huge things. Yes. Okay. Leg, thank you. Now, what I was saying about Riddell, stop it. Hold on 1 second, guys. Hey. No. She's grabbed my cord. Let's play with everything, and she just grabbed my, controller cord, so I just stop her. But anyway, for those of you who know, I live in New England, which has been pounded by snow for the past month. And we're expecting another snowstorm soon. And there's, like, no place to put it. Like, a lot of even main roads have, literally half some of their lanes are cut off because... Like, the snow is, like, migrating on the median next to the sidewalk and everything like that. Like, there's no place to put it. And, of course, even though there's a huge river in my town, you can't dump it in the river because there's rules against that. Because of all the, like, the salt content in it and, like, you know, other debris from the road, such as, you know, oil and things like that, so you can't... What the hell is this lag? You can't contaminate the river. There it is. Why won't you spawn in there? I haven't taken one yet, so there shouldn't be any missing. I wouldn't even let me use my tool cable. Let me go over here for a second. Why won't it spawn in there? One right here. Yeah, I know I'm being dragged. But if it's gonna prevent me from throwing it into something stupid like that, then I'm all for it. They should really invent is like some kind of like giant reactor thing and have a way to, like, you know, like, remove the snow and, like, dump it in a thing. And then, like, take, like, a giant flamethrower to it and, like, melt it. And then, you know, somehow extract, like, you know, like, the slot content and, like, the oils and, like, the other impurities in it. And then, voila! Fresh water! Sort of. You know, some very... No, I need to go this way. Some very efficient method to get rid of all the snow and recycle it. There we go. It only took 3 minutes to get that done. At least I actually did it. What the hell is this light coming from? There's a little tiny tow cable. Wait, is my tractor beam working? I can hear it humming. What the hell? Sorry, I need to take a bomb and blow you up first. And that was surprisingly easier than I expected it to be. Okay, now it's off. I could have sworn I heard the tractor beam humming and, like, something got, saw something get sucked into it. I don't mind we need to blow that thing up to get rid of the snow. That's just retarded. I mean, I know what obviously the heat from the reaction, whoops, melts the snow, but you tell me we couldn't do that on our own. You know, with bombing the wall behind it. Can I just blow up? Yeah, I just blew up. Alright, let me get rid of this crap. So yeah, snow is not my friend now. And I'm not one to complain about the weather too much because it's something we can't control. Like, I know people, it's like, oh, it's gonna be cold out today. Oh, it's gonna be rainy out today. Like, every little thing with the weather, they bitch about. It's like, it's the weather. It's like, oh, the weatherman says this, the weatherman says that. You know, it's like, what the weathermen say is a prediction. It's not necessarily going to be accurate, because Mother Nature is going to do what the hell she wants. So I don't really worry about the weather too much, unless it gets really extreme. Because like I said, there's nothing I can do about it, but, you know, prepare for the worst and hope for the best. But the amount of snow we've got, this is just ridiculous. And we've already had... one snowstorm, like the first one, yielded us like 20 inches, and everything after that has been like 6 plus. Obviously with no time for this crap to melt! We're only like 30-something days in the season. That's what really chaps my ass. But we got spoiled in the fall, and it was too warm, and there's consequences to that. Damn it. Funny thing is, my mom even mentioned she thought we were going to get hit hard this winter because we had such an easy fall. And she was right. Plus, this is New England, you know. Extreme weather is a thing, and I still can't stand people who complain about it. It's like, oh, it said that we're going to miss. It's like, it's New England. It's like, we're known for, you know, if you don't like the weather, wait 5 minutes. Because it can change very quickly. I remember one year in particular, probably about 13 years ago, maybe 14. No, probably about 13 is right. I was in middle school, and on the last day before of school, before Christmas vacation, in the afternoon, it snowed a crap ton. Like, seriously, there was a foot. I mean, it snowed so quickly. There was, like, a foot. It didn't even start till, like, lunchtime, and there was already, like, a foot of snow on the ground by the time we left for school. They actually dismissed school, like, 45 minutes early because of the snow. I mean, it was coming down. But thankfully, it was, I think it was, like, kind of like the light, fluffy one, which isn't too hard to deal with, but it was just so much of it at once. I remember having to climb over a snowbank to get home. But anyway, like 2 or 3 days later, it's Christmas Eve. It is 63 degrees out, and all the snow is melted. Yeah, talk about going from one extreme. Wait, is that last probe droid? or whatever the hell that thing is called. This probe droid just sounds nasty to me for some reason. There he is. So yeah, talk about a shift in the weather. And it was already winter time by then. It's very unusual to have a 60 degree day in the winter. Hell, it's even like, it's snow in the springtime, if I'm not allowed. I've seen snow as late as Memorial Day, for crying out loud. Just like very, very, very light flurries, but still considered snow. But even though snow is annoying, I wouldn't give it up. I actually do like, because of my ships, experiencing a true four seasons where I live. It's the way I've grown up, and like I couldn't move somewhere, even though obviously it's cold up here. I get used to the cold, and frankly, I find it easier to... See, now the tractor beam is working again! Why the heck is it working off and on? Oh, it's because I have the power up. That's what it is. That's it. I was going to say, I'm like, I can hear it, and I saw something get sucked into it. It's the power up. I forgot it gives you the tractor beam. And it's on. Oh yeah, droids. So people have to park. Oh, they're right next. Oh, this is bullshit, right? Bull friggin' shit right here. I've never seen them spawn right next to each other like that before. As far as I had enough room to get in there. Yeah, I couldn't. I don't think I could live in Florida. Too much humidity, and frankly, I think a blizzard is a little less threatening than a hurricane. Yeah, that was my idiotic driving, or flying in this case. Oops, missed him. There we go. What really sucks is there's two damn vehicle levels in here. I mean, I'm 10 minutes into the story already. And I'm only in the first level. But then again, I also do suck at this longer. Okay, where is the AT-AT level? Oh, right next to a bomb station. Nice. And of course, there's nothing else around it for me to kill. Now they come. What I usually do is I take off that walker first. Because usually the other ones creep up on you and you can shoot them while you're trying to wait for the tow cable to strip it. But no, not in this case. Got it. Okay, shift to the next sequence already. Thank you. Well, I have been worse at the level, but I have been a lot better, too. Oh, no! Yes, you're gonna catch up to that huge thing. Yeah, I know they walk slowly, but... And he dies. Damn it. Well, like 15 minutes into the video, we're finally on chapter 2. The rest of this should go by a little faster. But it's like, they already, but the thing is, so the Empire already knows you're there, so what good is it really, if, I mean, obviously, people will do anything to save their own asses, but now that they know where you are, they can track you leaving. Like, seriously. Oh, Pardon me, I'm trying to blow my nose as quietly as possible here. Oh no! What is with the lag today? In the shame, I only got 15,000 studs. Building thing is here. I'm using this for another part of the level. I love how they have these, obviously, heat generators just everywhere, and you know, just piled up on the ground everywhere. Can you melt the door already so I can go through it? Push it. No, I'm not gonna sing. That's Luke and Jin's job. Yeah, I had to die eventually. Build that, because we're gonna need this. Where'd you come from, you bastard? Give me the studs. And you- What the hell? What the hell is that happening in this game? I am not fully convinced that the PC version is, like, just so friggin' glitched, it's not even funny. Will you push this thing? Thank you. Damn, I don't need to get up there. That's okay. Oh, they fixed the problem of that exploding into studs that you couldn't get because they disappear before you even get to this part. Which I suppose is a very good thing. Yeah, I know you slow 3PO, but you take forever to get here anyway. Kitchen, go get him. No, that's the other one. I want this one. No, get on there. Thank you. Oh, the power, now I get the power up. I like this vehicle. It's kind of interesting how they did this puzzle. Oh, thankfully he didn't like just blow off again. There we go. I don't know why that thing slipped right through him, but whatever. I'm shooting it in the middle! Why isn't it exploding? Okay, well... Can we try the other one? No, the other one's too far. Why? Do I have to, like, beat up all these guys before it'll let me? What the hell, game? What the hell?